I am Pearl Akanya Ofori, and this is City News Daily on City TV. Coming up today, police pick up three people over the post-election violence in the country. Details of that shortly. So today, the presidential transition team resumed work after going on break for 2 days. The representative of the president-elect on the transition team, Osafo Marfo, asked for clarity on an alleged new recruitment into the public sector and the award of fresh contracts days after the National Democratic Congress lost the elections. He said such last-minute deals could have far-reaching consequences for the incoming administration. Osafo Marfo was speaking at the plenary session of today's transition team meeting.
We have heard from the grapevine a few things which have become our concern, talking about the incoming government team, the transition team. For instance, we have heard about ongoing recruitment into the security services now, which we hope is not true. We've heard of conversion of temporary staff, of political assistants, and some of the staff we took on into permanent public servants. We've heard of award of new contracts after the election results are announced on the 9th of December. We've heard of procurement of sales and national assets also after the results. We do not want to believe that these allegations are true. I personally, I don't. And therefore, I'm asking my colleague, the chief of staff, that after the election and the results have been declared, and the change is not from the government handing over to itself. There are two modes of transition. One transition is the government handing over to itself, as it happened to us in 2004 and happened to NDC in 2012. But in 2000 and 2016, the government handing over to another political party's government. The system is a little different. We need to be cautious. We need to be transparent, we need to be candid, and we need to be factual. We are therefore appealing to our colleagues that within this period, if there's anything that needs to be done, consultation has to be brought on board.
At the same event, the Chief of Staff, Julius Zebra, said most of the documentation required from government for the transition to proceed smoothly are ready.
I think now we have almost all the handing over notes ready, and the reason is this. Per the law, all the handing over notes were supposed to be ready by September. But as we all agree, between September and December, naturally a few things might have taken place. And so we agreed amongst ourselves to get everything that needed to be tied up done. But the good news is that as we speak now, the handing over notes from Ministry of Finance, Ministry of Lands, Minister of Transport, Chieftaincy, Food and Agriculture, Fisheries, Interior and Defense are ready. And we'll make sure that the others that are left will also be ready by Monday, as has been agreed between myself and my senior colleague.
97.3 City FM. Relevant radio, always.
The Africa Center for Parliamentary Affairs is confident that Ghana's next parliament under the leadership of Professor Mike Ocquaye will be efficient. The former MP for the Domi Kwabinya constituency has been widely tipped to become the next Speaker of Parliament. The MPP will command an overwhelming majority of about 170 members of parliament in the House, which some analysts fear may have implications for checks and balances on critical bills. But the executive director of the African Center for Parliamentary Affairs, Dr. Rashid Dramani, believes Professor Mike Ocquaye will do a fine job at ensuring good laws are passed. The Greater Accra Regional Organizer of the National Democratic Congress, Anthony Nukpenu, is blaming former President Jerry John Rawlings for the party's defeat in the December 7th polls. According to him, Jerry John Rawlings publicly painted the party as corrupt, which the NPP capitalized on to campaign against them. Some political analysts have said a lot of Ghanaians voted against the NDC over the recurring corruption scandals under the Mahama-led administration. The NPP won with an overwhelming 53.85% of the total votes cast against the NDC's 44.4%. Now, Anthony Nukpenu tells City News, Jerry John Rawlings must take responsibility for the defeat. The police administration say that they have arrested three people allegedly connected to the recent wave of post-election violence across the country. In Accra, some youth believed to be affiliated to the New Patriotic Party took over toll booths and some public facilities, while others allegedly assaulted members of the National Democratic Congress. Well, the New Patriotic Party condemned the attacks and charged the police to deal with the perpetrators. The Director of Public Affairs of the Ghana Police Service, Superintendent Savers Arthur, tells City News three people have been arrested, but other suspects are currently on the run. And on that note, we wrap up today's edition of City News Daily on City TV. I am Pearl Akanya Ofori. As always, thanks for your time.
Second image international admissions in progress. Courses available include hairdressing, beauty therapy and fashion. Call us 1-0243-331-999. Evening and weekend classes are also available.